New MG4 EV electric crossover hard antidote attack on a direct competitor, Renault Mégane. Buying a car is without a doubt an exciting experience, but selecting the best automobile for your needs is not always simple. On the other hand, there's an answer to every predicament. If you're interested in the MG4 EV and the Renault Mégane E-Tech Electric 2023, we might have the answer to all of your questions. Now, you may be wondering which one's the superior option, and why should you consider the new possibilities rather than the ones that have already been explored? You want to know the answers? Well, stay tuned. Hey, folks, welcome back to Tech Electric. In today's video, we're going to talk about the comparisons between the MG4 EV and the Renault Mégane E-Tech. So stay with us till the end of the video so you don't miss out on any of this information. And before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell symbol so you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. The new MG4 is MG's entry into the market for reasonably priced, fully electric family cars. Now that the pricing and specifications have been made public, MG has stated that its new electric vehicle will be available beginning in September of this year. We were initially introduced to the zero-emissions MG4 and its Chinese specification as the Mulan-badged electric vehicle, and we now know that it will ride on the brand's new MSP, Modular Scalable Platform Architecture. The new platform that will form the backbone of the next generation of electric MG models will be based on the MG4, which highlights the MG4's place as a vital player in the continuous all-electric assault that MG is launching in the UK market. Now, let's take a look at specs, prices, and configurations. It should not come as a surprise that the MG4 Long Range SE has the longest range of all the available models, clocking in at 281 miles. This is because of the larger 64 kilowatt-hour battery, which also has a charging capability of 135 kilowatts. This results in a charging period of 35 minutes when using a 150 kilowatt quick charger. Long-range SE vehicles are equipped with MG's grille shutter technology, which controls the amount of airflow through the grille based on the needs of the vehicle. MG claims that this increases the vehicle's EV range by as much as 10% and improves the vehicle's aerodynamic efficiency by up to 30%. Long-range SE models start at 28,495 pounds. The MG4 EV Trophy is the most expensive model available, with prices starting at £31,495. When equipped with a larger 64 kilowatt-hour battery, MG asserts that the EV Trophy has a driving range of 270 miles. In addition to that, it comes with an improved model of the MG Pilot system, as well as a number of new safety features like blind spot identification, lane change assist, and rear cross traffic alert. In addition to that, it also comes standard with a two-tone roof, rear privacy glass, double aero rear spoiler, leather interior with electric driver seat, heated front seats and steering wheel, satellite navigation, 360-degree camera, and wireless phone charging. The exact performance data have not been disclosed. However, the model with 201 horsepower and 64 kilowatt-hour battery capacity will be able to accelerate from 0 to 62 miles per hour in less than 8 seconds. The maximum allowed speed is 99 miles an hour. The platform, as well as the powertrain. It has been established by MG that the MSP platform is capable of housing all-wheel drive electric powertrains, and the company is working on a future development of the MG4 that will include a dual motor system. MG further claims that its MSP will support battery swapping systems and that its service-oriented architecture will make it possible for vehicles to receive updates wirelessly over the air throughout their entire life cycle. We believe the new MG4 EV will be an intriguing option for customers wanting an affordable electric car without compromise, said Guy Pijanakis, commercial director at MG Motor UK. We expect our new MG4 EV to be available later this year. The revolutionary modular scalable platform has a significant amount of untapped potential and is expected to produce a number of fascinating new MGs over the course of the next few years. The head of product and planning at MG Motor UK, David Allison, has been quoted as saying in the past that MG4 EV is a critical part of the next phase of growth for MG. Our outstanding reputation for outstanding design, market-leading technology, and excellent value for money will be strengthened by any choice you make, thanks to our outstanding new MSP architecture, which will enable us to offer multiple options for the rapidly expanding electric car market in the UK. Let's take a look at the design. Utilizing a new design language, its exterior design is completely distinct from that of any other model in the current MG lineup. This is due to the fact that the car was designed using an entirely new design language. At the front, a rather pointed front end is denoted by slim and pointed-looking LED headlights, and at the back, a full-width LED taillight bar lies beneath the screen. Both of these features are LED. The cladding that runs along the bottom of the doors is a more rugged appearance, and the top of the hatch lid is crowned with a rear spoiler that is a split design. These design elements are reminiscent of SUVs. The all-new Megane E-Tech electric crossover is Renault-Nissan's next electric automobile step. Based on Renault's new CMF EV platform, itself based on the CMF C platform, but with a more compact nose, flatter floor, and reworked suspension, technology previewed we'll see on the next group's automobiles in the future. This corporation may import a limited number of E-Techs as a technological demonstrator. So what about Renault's E-Tech Electric? The car's exterior is easy to spot. The car/crossover/SUV has an unusual profile with its large wheels, high waist, and low roof. Senior management liked the new Megane so highly that it became the standard model. The clean-cut nose, 20-inch wheels, and arrowhead embellishments on the chin look terrific. Go down the road in this and you'll be noticed, gold highlights or not. This front-wheel drive automobile employs 40 kilowatt-hours or 60 kilowatt-hour pouch lithium-ion batteries. On the 60 kilowatt model, this DC rapid charging can reach 130 kilowatts, charging 70 to 75% in 30 minutes. The 40 kilowatt-hour model charges slower, but can accept 22 kilowatts from an AC charger. So how does Renault's E-Tech Electric drive? Let's start with ride and handling, where Renault thinks this car shines. Yes, riding comfort is great. We don't feel the weight of the battery, even as we stomp over Spain's less than perfect roads. There's no looseness, and despite the big wheels, there's no excessive unsprung mass. Big wheels tap-tap over road ridges, but the lengthy wheelbase doesn't move much, therefore smaller wheels are better. The E-Tech is agile for a big wheelbase. The car loves corners, responds enthusiastically to the steering lock, and feels tiny. And it rolls, especially on switchbacks, but speeding out of a corner disrupts the front suspension and produces vagueness. Renault engineers said they'll soon remedy this. This Renault's more efficient than older generation electric cars of its size since it's lighter. Starting with 100% and 367 kilometers, we ended with 37% and 141 kilometers. Correlating with distance traveled, it would suggest a range of around 345 kilometers, which is surprisingly impressive and seems to back up Renault's claim of having an efficient battery and motor setup. Inside the Renault E-Tech Electric, the instrument panel's curved glass with a tablet-sized portrait screen running Google Automotive Services. With Google Maps and Voice Assistant, you don't need to sync your phone to the car. The screen isn't as sharp as an iPad, but you don't need to tap it twice, and you have physical air con controls. Top quality steering wheel and surfaces make the cabin feel premium. The chrome and piano black pieces, mood lighting, chrome buttons, and high-grain materials make the cabin feel upscale. The fake wood trim isn't spectacular, but I like the smart use of movable stoppers, which prevents your odds and ends from sliding around in the deep central tunnel underneath the primary console. Hey, that's going to do it for today's video, guys. We sincerely appreciate you for tuning in today. And if you like the video, please make sure you click on the like button, share it with your friends and family. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our videos. Hey, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.